everyone, welcome back to the YouTube channel that is ESA means English with Sumaya Azam, and this is your English teacher from Gardenia Public School. Here we are going to start a new topic from the poetry section of CBSC 9, that is Wind. Actually, this poem was written earlier in Tamil. In Tamil, it was written by Subramanya Bharti, but later on, it was translated into English, and that was done by A.K. Ramanujan. Actually, I don't understand that what was the need of translating one poem from Tamil to English. Somehow, it has just increased the syllabus of English. Nothing else. Okay, so now when it has been already increased, so let us move further and go through the explanation of the poem Wind from a poetry section of CBSC class 9th. Starting with the explanation of poem, let us go through the summary of the poem. Actually, the poem is about wind and its unlimited powers. In this poem, the poet is every time requesting the wind to come softly. Actually, that because of the power of the wind, because of the intensity of the wind was just breaking down all the things. All the windows and all the shutters of the windows and the books on the shelf, each and everything was scattered by the wind. So here the poet is every time requesting the wind to come softly. He asked it not to throw the books down from the shelf, but the request had no effect on it. The poet also blames wind that it is very clever in teasing the weaklings. Means the poet here himself considering him as a weak person. Among the things which the wind was scattering all, he also considers the bookshelf and then the shutters of the windows, each and everything he was considering themselves to be very soft and to be very weak. So in that very manner only, the poet is also blaming the wind that it is very clever in teasing the weaklings. According to the poet, wind itni intensity ke saath thi, to according to him it was like that it is just teasing those other things. So this is how the poem starts. Further, the poet also takes the example of a fire. According to the poet, what poet says is that when the fire is not that strong, the fire strong nahi hoti, light hoti, and because of the wind it just gets off. But then when that same fire is stronger, the wind can't do anything. Wind ki wajah se wo fire aur bhi zyada strong ho jati hai. Agar hum baat kare ek chote se diye ki, whenever we let the lamp or something, or because of the wind it gets extinguished, wo bujh jata hai. But if we same talk about a forest fire of a wild fire, agar wahan pe wind hoti hai to the same fire becomes so fierce aur wo aur bhi zyada spread ho jati hai. So this same example was taken by the poet also here in the poem. So let us go through the poem and see that what all things the poet tells us. Here is the first stanza. As it is said, wind, come softly, don't break the shutters of the windows, don't scatter the papers, don't throw down the books on the shelf. There, look what you did. You threw them all down. You tore the pages of the books. You brought rain again. So, actually, the worst part of this poem is, or we can say something about this poem is that this poem is having no rhyming scheme. You won't find any rhyming scheme here in this poem. As you can see also here, the last verse of each and every line, they all are different. They are nowhere making any of the rhyming scheme. So let us start with the explanation of the first stanza. Here in the first stanza, the poet is somewhere complaining to the wind. Wind se complain kar raha hai at every time that because of the wind, all the shutters of the windows have been broke down. It is getting the scatters. It is just scattering away all the papers. And in the same very manner, the poet is also complaining the wind not to throw down the books on the shelf. Jo shelf pe jo books rakhi hain, because of the intensity of the wind, each and every book is just getting fallen down. And then again it complains that see what you have done. It is again complaining to that wind. The poet is complaining to that wind that just see what you have done. You have thrown away, you have just scattered away all the books which were kept there on the shelf. And also you have torn the pages of the book. Meri book ke jo pages the, you have just torn them all. यू ब्रॉट द रेन अगेन एंड बिकॉज ऑफ यू ओनली अगेन इट स्टार्टेड रेनिंग हियर. वन थिंग, द फिगर ऑफ स्पीच ऑफ दिस पोएम इज, द फिगर ऑफ स्पीच ऑफ दिस स्टैंजा इज एनाफोर. Now, what is this anaphor? Let us see. Students, anaphor is when two or three consecutive lines start with the same word. जब हमारे दो से तीन consecutive lines जो होती हैं and when it starts with the same words, that is known as anaphor. So here we can see that this don't and don't. These three consecutive lines are starting with the same word. So the figure of the speech used in the first stanza is anaphor. Let us move further. Moving further to the second stanza, what it says? You are very clever at poking fun at weaklings, frail crumbling houses, crumbling doors, crumbling rafters, crumbling wood, crumbling bodies, crumbling lives, crumbling hearts. The wind god winnows and crushes them all. What the poet is saying further, what does this line mean? At poking fun at weaklings. Here somewhere the poet is describing that the wind knows it very well that how to tease the weak people. Weak people ko kaise tease karna hai. Here the wind knows each and everything. So this is what the poet says, that you are very clever and you know it very well that how I have to make fun of the weak people. You are just making all that fun of the crumbling houses which are already getting destroyed. The crumbling doors, rafters, wood. And whatsoever the things are there, you are making just fun of all these things. जो भी हमारी weak doors है, weak woods है, weak hearts है, weak bodies, you are just making fun of all those. Further, the wind god winnows and crushes them all. Here the poet is saying that the wind god winnows. What is meant by winnows? If you just remind a bit, if you go to your previous classes, then previous classes we have studied of a topic that is called winnowing, which was also a process of separation of substances, जहाँ पे हम unwanted substances को we just remove from that. Majorly we have studied about the grains there, where a person stands at a higher platform and just thrashes out the things. और उसकी वजह से बिकॉज ऑफ द विंड ऑल द हेवियर पार्टिकल्स रिमेन इन दैट वेसल और इन दैट कंटेनर एंड ऑल द लाइटर वंस जस्ट मूव अवे फ्रॉम देयर. सो दिस द सेम थिंग इट इज सेइंग दैट द विंड गॉड इज समवे विनोइंग द वीकलिंग्स. जो हमारे वीकर पार्टिकल्स हैं या वी कैन से व्हाटएवर द वीकर थिंग्स आर देयर, जैसे कि हमारे विंडोज, डोर्स, हाउसेस, वुड, व्हाटएवर द वीकलिंग, हूसोएवर आर द वीकलिंग्स, here the god is just winnowing them and just crushing them all. So this is what was about the second stanza. Let us move further to the third stanza. So what the third stanza says, he won't do what you tell him, so come, let's build strong homes, let's join the doors firmly, practice to firm the body, make the heart steadfast, do this and the wind will be friends with us. We can relate this stanza completely with a person's life. It may happen that several times humko tease kiya jata because we are unable to perform any such activity. Koi aisi activity hoti which we are unable to perform and we have been teased in that part by the other people. So what the poet is actually trying to explain us is ki ye world jo hai, this cruel world, ye hamare according nahi chalegi. But then the thing is, if you really want to face this world, if you really want to survive over here, is the only option with you is you have to make yourself strong. अपने आप को इतना मजबूत करना होगा, अपने आप को इतना strong करना होगा that the other persons are not able to teach you. But the poet also tells us that let us come and make our home so strong. अपने घर को हम इतना strong बनाए, अपने doors को इतना strongly we should firm them, we should make our hearts so strong that the others are not able to beat us. So this is what the poet also tells us, that if you really want to survive this world, agar is duniya ko really survive karna hai, the only solution with you is that you have to make yourself that strong that no other person is able to beat you. And the most important thing is you never have to let other persons know that what your weak zones are. So this is how you will be able to survive in this world. Let us move to the last stanza of the poem and let's see that what message the poet delivers there. So here's the last stanza. It says, the wind blows out weak fires. He makes strong fire roar and flourish. His friendship is good. We praise him every day. So what the poet is trying to explain here is that here the poet takes an example of one, we can say it takes a, he takes the example of fire. Ke jaise ek hum diya kar lete, we lit a earthen lamp or something, and if the fire is not that strong, it's a weak one, so with the wind it just blows out. Jo wind hoti hai wo us dheemi aag ko bujha deti hai. But then if we talk of a wildfire or if we talk of any of the forest fire, and there the wind makes it even more and more fierce. Wo aur bhi zyada fierce hoti chali jati hai. It just flourish and just damages each and everything. Har cheez ko wo khatam kar jati hai. It simply destroys everything. So what the poet says is that his friendship is good and we praise him every day. Now why the friendship is good? Because somehow this is something jisne us ek weak इंसान को ही मेक्स हिम दैट अ स्ट्रॉन्गर वन, एक मजबूर कर देता है. कहते हैं कि लाइफ में ऐसे सर्कमस्टेंसेस होते हैं विच मेक्स अ पर्सन स्ट्रॉन्गर. कई बार ऐसा होता है वी फेस सच सर्कमस्टेंसेस कि ठीक है ऑल्दो दैट टाइम इज नॉट फाइन, बट देन बिकॉज ऑफ दोज थिंग्स ओनली वी बिकम सो स्ट्रॉन्ग. फेसिंग ऑल दो सर्कमस्टेंसेस इट बिल्ड्स अस इवन स्ट्रॉन्गर एंड स्ट्रॉन्गर. एज इट इज सेड दैट एक्सपीरियंस इज द बेस्ट टीचर. Experience is the best teacher. जितना ज्यादा आप experience करते हो, you just innovate yourself that much. आप अपने आप को उतना ही ज्यादा glorify करते हो, अपने ही आप को उतना ज्यादा enhance करते हो. This is what was all about the poem. Let us go through the summary of the poem again and see that what was the message delivered by the poet. Stay tuned with us.
So the summary of the poem. This poem is about wind and its unlimited powers. The poet requests the wind god to come softly. He requests him not to break the shutters of windows and not to scatter the papers. He asks it not to throw the books down from the shelf, but the request had no effect on it. The poet blames wind that it is very clever in teasing the weaklings. It crumbles frail houses, doors, rafters, wood, bodies, lives and hearts. Then the poet gives example of fire. He says that a weak fire is put off by the strong wind, but when the wind is also strong and along with that wind the fire is also strong, the wind cannot extinguish the fire, rather it makes it much stronger. Therefore he advises us to become stronger and fight with it. He requests to make stronger houses and join the doors firmly. He also requests to firm the body so that we can fight the wind easily. He says that the friendship of wind is good. Thus, the poet tells us that if a person is capable, even his enemies become his friend. On the other hand, if a person is weak, even nature makes fun of him. In a way, the poet is trying to establish the universally known dictum, survival of the fittest.